Welcome to Fluke Connect. This video will show you how to activate your 3561 vibration sensors and 3502 gateway using the Fluke Connect app. Before the in-app setup, you should have already confirmed your Wi-Fi settings, downloaded the Fluke Connect app, and unboxed your starter kit. If you need help with your Wi-Fi settings, please visit fluke.com/quickstart. On your mobile device, launch the Fluke Connect app and select Setup Logging or Monitoring. Select Vibration Sensors and Start Session Setup. Plug in the gateway and enable Bluetooth on your mobile device. You can move the gateway to another outlet after it's activated. Keep your mobile device within 4 inches of the gateway to make sure it's detected. Select the gateway you'd like to set up. First-time users will have to add their Wi-Fi network by selecting New Network. Enter your network name, also known as an SSID, and type the password. Select your security level. WEP is the most common, but WPA2 is often used for increased security on commercial networks. The app will automatically start activating your gateway. Hold your phone within 4 inches of the gateway and wait until you see the message, "Provisioning completed." With the gateway ready, it's time to activate your sensors. Hold your mobile device within 4 inches of the sensors. Now that your sensor has been found, select the box associated with the serial number on the sensor and continue. Add your company details and select Activate. After you've viewed the terminology, screen tap Continue. Select Assign an Asset or Test Point. This is where you specify the equipment that your sensors will be monitoring. Fluke Connect uses this information to send you alarms. You can learn more about asset types and test points on this screen and select Continue. Tap on the 3 dots next to Asset Groups and add an asset. Asset groups serve as folders that allow you to categorize and organize your equipment. If the asset doesn't specifically fall under a group, simply select Add Asset to save it in the Ungrouped Asset folder. Enter the name and tap Asset Type. Select your asset type. Once back on the New Asset screen, select Next. Now you will set the health status of your asset. If you perceive your asset to be in normal working condition, select Normal, then Save. Find your asset in the group where you saved it. Select it and tap Save and Continue. The system requires more information about the machine category to send instant alarms. Tap Machine Category, make a selection, then use the Back button in the top left. The default temperature unit is Celsius, but it can be changed with one tap. The next step is configuring the alarms. Alarms are triggered automatically based on the asset information you provided in prior steps. Choose which team members should receive alarms and select Save and Continue. The next 2 screens summarize your settings. Review them and tap Install Sensors. The last step is epoxying the sensors to the equipment. The app will prompt you to confirm installation and take you back to the home screen. If you're confident in the Wi-Fi connection at the installation site, you can proceed with the epoxy. However, if you have any doubts, we highly recommend testing your connection before applying the epoxy. To verify your Wi-Fi connection before installing, tap Finish Setup. Even though your sensors are not installed, select Yes. Go to the home screen and scroll to View Active Monitoring Sessions. Select the session and check to see if data is flowing. This can take up to 5 minutes. Now you can epoxy the sensors and complete installation. For additional resources, visit fluke.com/quickstart.